स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव डन टू चैप्टर्स इन केमिस्ट्री इन क्लास 9th, दैट इज लैंग्वेज ऑफ केमिस्ट्री एंड केमिकल चेंजेस एंड रिएक्शंस. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द प्रैक्टिकल पार्ट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री. वी कैन ऑल्सो कॉल इट एज प्रैक्टिकल केमिस्ट्री और प्रोजेक्ट वर्क. यू विल बी अवॉर्डेड 20 मार्क्स फॉर मेंटेनिंग प्रैक्टिकल फाइल. And also you will be asked question in examination from this part of chemistry. Not only in 9th class, in 10th class also questions may be asked from this part of the chemistry. These are some general information regarding some of the compounds and the gases which we come across during the study of chemistry. Here the first topic in our syllabus in practical part is identification and the recognition of gases. In our syllabus we are having different topics, and first one is this one. In this part we are having study of hydrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, water vapor, nitrogen dioxide, chlorine, hydrogen chloride, sulfur dioxide, ammonia, etc. Up till now we have done chapter, or better I should say you have done chapters up to 8th class in our course books, from our course books. But from class 9th we are having project cum practical work in chemistry. Practical work you have to do in practical file. These files are available in markets or bookshop. You can take it of any brand available according to your convenience. Up to this class you are familiar about gases present in atmosphere like hydrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, water vapor, some inert gases also, some other gases you also come across during the study of chemistry like nitrogen dioxide, sulfur dioxide, ammonia and many other gases. In 9th class we are going to study about detection of gases by performing simple physical test and in some cases chemical tests also for confirmation. Physical tests include finding out the color, odor, litmus test, combustibility, etc. Here in color we will find out whether the gas is colorless or colored in nature, or particular odor which the gas is carrying. And third one is the litmus test. Litmus test is being done by using blue or red litmus paper. These tests help in finding out whether the particular gas is acidic, basic or neutral in nature. Combustibility, it shows that whether the gas is supporter or non-supportive combustion, or whether it is combustible or non-combustible in nature, the gas burns itself or it doesn't burn. The word rekindle is also used in some cases. The rekindle word means a lit wooden splinter, or we can say glowing wooden splinter or a burning wooden splinter is taken near the gas and it started burning brightly. It means the gas is a supporter of combustion. Next is the chemical test. Chemical tests are the confirmatory tests. The gases are proved by using confirmatory chemical test. Or we finally come to a conclusion that the particular gas is this one gas by using a particular chemical reagent. Some of the chemical reagent which we use are potassium permanganate, potassium dichromate, lime water, etc. Firstly, we will start with a gas, hydrogen and oxygen. In this class we will study about hydrogen and oxygen. I am going to give you PDF for writing how to write this particular experiment of hydrogen and oxygen in your practical file. Firstly, we will study the nature of the gas hydrogen. The gas is colorless, odorless gas. You also have studied hydrogen in 8th class also. We are having a chapter of hydrogen in 9th class also. Colorless, odorless gas which is neutral in nature means it will not react to blue or either red it must paper. This gas is neutral in nature. This gas is a non-supporter of combustion. Means it doesn't support combustion. It extinguishes a burning wooden splinter with pop sound. When this gas comes in contact of, that is hydrogen gas comes in contact of oxygen, it reacts explosively. It reacts in a manner and a voice comes which we call as pop sound. Okay, then whether the gas is combustible in nature, so it is combustible in nature, and that is it burns itself. It burns with blue flame in contact of the gas oxygen. Next one is oxygen. Khalil, you are familiar about this gas. We all know that this gas is a supporter of combustion, and 21% of oxygen is present in the atmosphere, and only due to this gas the things burns in air. This gas is colorless, odorless gas which is neutral in nature, means it will again give no effect on either blue or red litmus paper. It is non-combustible in nature. It itself doesn't burn, but it is supporter of combustion. Because it support combustion, it rekindles a glowing wooden splinter. If we take a burning wooden splinter near the gas, it will burn brightly, or we can also say it will not extinguish. It shows that this gas is a supporter of combustion. In this practical part of chemistry, we will also study some other tests like flame test. We means the color of the ion imparted to the flame when any metallic ion is subjected to flame of Bunsen burner. We will also study effect of heat on compounds. So, in the PDF work or homework, I have given you the the experiment, how to write the particular experiment in the practical file. So, do it properly in the practical file and maintain your practical record, because you will be awarded marks, and also learn it properly, study it properly. Because you must be having questions based on this part of chemistry. These are general important information in chemistry which you should know and study.